Lesson 1. Introduction to Poetry. Today I am annotating the major elements of poetry so that I can become a more proficient reader of poetry. I will know I have met the objective when I have correctly identified the element of poetry demonstrated in at least 4 out of 5 examples. Ardu now asks us to use a circle map to brainstorm everything you already know or have heard about poetry in the box below. Remember that a brainstorm map looks like a donut. So, we're going to write poetry in the center because this is the topic of what we are brainstorming. Then I create my outer circle. And in my circle map, I'm going to write everything I know about poetry. So, for example, I know that poetry rhymes. I know that poetry can be like a song. I know we learn about poetry in school. Now it's your turn to come up with 3 more things that you already know about poetry. It can be anything. It could be that you don't like it. It could be that you do like it. It could be a poem that you've heard. It could be something about figurative language. What do you already know about poetry? When you have those 3 things, move on to the notes section. This part was intended to be an anticipation guide to see what you already knew. We're going to go through, though, and simply match the definitions with my help. Using specific words on purpose is called word choice. This helps us, like if an author uses a specific word, it's for a specific reason. To carry or transport is see, convey. A comparison between 2 unlike things is a figurative language, and that can be a simile or a metaphor. Repetition of similar sounds in words is repetition. It could be rhyme, so I'm going to wait to do that one. 1 or 2 words or a complete sentence is line length, so that's F. An author's attitude towards a subject is their tone. Remember, don't take that attitude with me. But the feeling created by the author is the mood. A simple sentences or compound sentences are sentence structures, so that's I. Repeated sounds, words, or phrases is repetition. See how it has repeated and repetition. The stress pattern in words and syllables is rhythm. And if we go back to the one we skipped, that's rhyme. When you're ready, let's go on to the next section. All right. Our essential question for this phase of the unit is, how do authors use poetic devices to enhance the meaning of their writing? Poetry is imaginative literature that is written in lines rather than sentences. Let's annotate that definition. Poetry is imaginative literature written in lines instead of sentences. Poets convey meaning and emotion, so they show their meaning and emotion in poetry through the use of word choice, figurative language, sentence structure, line length, punctuation, rhythm, repetition, and rhyme. We're going to take notes on these elements of poetry to prepare to be able to identify each element in a poem. Here's our first one. Poets search for original ways of describing things and expressing ideas. Word choice and sound in a poem is important. The fact that the poem uses a 1-syllable word instead of a 2-syllable word, or a word that begins with an S instead of a word that begins with a P, can affect the reader how the reader feels. Let's look at the example. The fact that a poet describes an athlete as buff instead of strong affects the picture of the reader forms of this person. So when I think of someone who's buff, I think of like Arnold Schwarzenegger with his like big muscles. But when I think of someone who's strong, I think of like a woman who's able to lift up a car when her baby is underneath it. So she's like strong, but she's not necessarily buff, right? That's the difference. So using those different words helps me understand the meaning of what's going on. Next word. Poets may also use figurative language to make imaginative comparison between 2 very different things. We've talked about figurative language a lot already this year. In this case, Chevy like a rock. So this one, they're comparing the Chevy car to a rock. They're saying that both of them are sturdy or reliable. Okay. Next one, a line is the basic unit of poetry. The length of one line might be very short, only one or two words long, or it might be very long. A line of poetry may contain exactly one complete sentence or not. Sometimes all lines in a poem are about the same length. At other times, different line lengths are used in a single poem. Poets use varying line lengths to create a tone or mood. So here we see sifted, unfallen snow, settling and unsettling snow, snow resting like mortar on the stone. This line is very short, this one is medium, and this one is very long. The author uses all the different types of line lengths to express a certain meaning in the poem. Next page. Like line length, sentence structure has a strong effect too. For example, when lines form simple sentences, they may sound childlike and innocent. When lines form compound complex sentences, the poem may sound more intellectual. So our example, oh, if to dance all night and dress all day charmed the smallpox or chased old age away, who would not scorn what his wife's cares produce, or who would learn one earthly thing of use? This is a very long sentence, so it is long and complex, even though the content that they're talking about is fairly childlike. Next one. Alliteration, or the repeated sounds, words, or phrases, can also affect tone or meaning, such as Sally sells seashells by the seashore. The word that was alliterated, or the sound that was alliterated, was the S sound. And then we have rhyme. Rhyme is the repetition of the stressed vowel sound and all the sounds that come after it. If a poem rhymes, you can often see it before you can even read it. You can see words with similar endings at the end of lines. For example, the farmer's cat said, I like snow. The farmer's rat said, I don't know. Cat rhymes with rat. We would label these both A in this poem. Snow rhymes with no. We would label those both B because these are the patterns of the rhymes. A, B, A, B. Now it's your turn to list as many words as you can think of that rhyme with cat in the box below. I already heard rat. I immediately think of hat and sat. Now, it's your turn to come up with at least three more words that rhyme with cat. And our last key concept, we have rhythm is the repetition of stressed and unstressed syllables. Poetry has its roots in music, and music has a rhythm or a beat. Language has a rhythm too. The sentences you speak every day in casual conversations have rhythms. You stress some words and syllables and others not. For instance, one, two, buckle my shoe. Three, four, shut the door. So the rhythm of this is one, two, buckle my shoe. Three, four, shut the door. That's pretty confusing. You'll learn more about it in high school and in college. Now, think of a song you like and write down 2 to 4 lines below. Can you hear the rhythm when you speak instead of seeking lines? This portion here will be extra credit. You don't need to do this section. Now, when we did this originally in class, we completed a close reading of The Raven by Edgar Allan Poe. Go ahead and cross this out. We're not going to work on this on the video. Same thing. We're not going to do the close reading of The Raven. You can go ahead and turn the page. Now, it's time for you to test your mastery on this first objective, annotating the major elements of poetry so you can become a more proficient reader of poetry. You will know you've met the objective when you have correctly identified the element of poetry described in at least 4 out of 5 examples. So you're going to read the 5 selections of poems and identify the element of poetry best shown in each selection. You'll circle the poetry element that the poem is an example of. So we see, now all that was left neath the bad-smelling sky was my big empty factory, the Lorax and I. Is this a best example of tone, figurative language, or line length? Number 2. Early to bed and early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy, and wise. Is this a good example of rhythm, figurative language, or repetition? Number 3. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. Is this an example of line length, repetition, or figurative language? Number 4. Not a box with a fox, not in a house with not with a mouse. Is this an example of figurative language, sentence structure, or rhyme? Number 5. Your teeth are like stars. They come out at night, they come back at dawn when they're ready to bite. Is this an example of figurative language, repetition, or sentence structure? If you struggled with these, remember to go back to your notes to help guide you answering these questions. Good job on this lesson. Hopefully you got at least 4 questions correct on this exit slip. Go ahead and move on to the next lesson if you're ready.